everyone. It's Melissa from Hugstrap. I was thinking that because the holidays are finished and it's January, that it is very likely there are plenty of people out there who just got their first year ukulele for the holidays and are probably busy scouring the internet looking for easy songs to play. So if you are brand new to the ukulele, and you are, just having a hard time even mastering like the C chord, I would say don't do this video just yet, but put it in your queue so you can do it maybe next. And go to my video for Lime the Coconut, which uses 2 1-fingered chords. It's just a C and a C7. It is great to get started. It's a nice, fun, easy song to play. Rhythm's really simple. Get started there, and then make sure you come to this one, because the next thing you're going to do once you kind of learned a few chords is you're going to want to start searching for songs that only have 3 or 4 chords, and there's plenty of them out there, and this one is in particular is a great one to start on, because not only is it 4 chords, and it's a C, F, G, and A minor, which should be the first 4 chords you learn, it is also really simple rhythmically, so it is a perfect beginner song. There are plenty of songs out there that don't use that many chords, but maybe they have a little bit more of a complicated strumming pattern, and maybe that's going to like throw you off a little bit when you're first starting out. But this song is perfect. It's Let It Be by the Beatles. It's beautiful and it's nice and calming, which is great when you're feeling stressed out. And it only uses 4 chords. So we're gonna learn that one today. So before we get started, you're gonna wanna go to the description box where you will find a free downloadable PDF tab so you can follow along with me. I'm also throwing the chords up in the corner so you can follow along as we go. Before we get started, also make sure you hit like and subscribe so you can find more videos like this, and it really helps me out, helps me grow the channel, and I appreciate it so much. Okay, so let's get started. like I said before, this is a great song for beginners because you only need C, F, G, and A minor. So those are very nice, simple chords. I'm gonna go over them very quickly for our beginners out there. Feel free to skip ahead if you already know these chords. So let me stand up so you can see what I'm doing. We're gonna start with a C chord. You should be playing this with either your ring or your pinky finger. For most beginners, you're gonna find this to be the most comfortable. Try not to do this. I know in the very beginning, your index finger might be your strongest finger, and that might seem like the best thing to do. And obviously, if you're struggling or have arthritis and this is the only way you can do it, go for it. But if you don't find this to be too burdensome, try and do your ring finger. The reason why is because when you go to switch to other chords, it is going to be much, much simpler if you're using your ring finger to go to an F, for example, because you used your ring and then you go straight to that F. See how it's already free to go? Okay, so speaking of which, let's learn the F chord. You're also gonna need to know that one. You're gonna use your index finger on the E string, first fret. Ring finger is going to go on the, I'm sorry, I take it back. Middle finger is going to go on the G string, second fret, okay? That's your F. You're going to need to know an A minor, which you're going to play like that by lifting up your index finger, and that is my middle finger on the second fret of the G string, A minor. And then we're going to need to know a G. This one's going to be the trickiest of the bunch. You're going to need to place your index finger here on the C string, second fret, middle finger on the A string, second fret, and my ring finger down here on the E string, third fret. This one will take a little bit of time to get to master, but it's a very useful chord and you will use it in a lot of songs, so make sure you learn it. One thing I should mention, if you are a person who has larger fingers, you might find this is a little uncomfortable. You might find it's a little bit hard to keep your fingers behind each other this way. You can always do this if this is more available to you. You can put your index finger across the first 3 strings and then place your ring finger down and play it that way too, okay? But pick whichever one makes the most sense. When you're first starting out, both of them are a little bit difficult, but you're gonna have to just keep practicing it. So you'll just keep going back and forth. I always tell my beginners to start this way, just to, you know, practice going back and forth between chords. So if I have to go between a C and a G in a song and I'm finding that transition difficult, before I start playing it, just go back and forth, play it, okay? All right, so let's get started on the song. So we're gonna start, the pattern goes C, G, A minor, F, C, G, F, C, and then we repeat it. Okay, so we're gonna go nice and slow. Our strum pattern is just going to be down strums to start. If you are finding that, you know, if you come to this and just, I really wanted to learn how to play this song, you don't have to stick down strums. You can make it a little more exciting. You could do down up. But right now, we're just gonna stick to a nice simple down strum, which we're gonna do by making, I'm gonna use all 4 of my fingers. I'm gonna tell you again that you do not have to do that. You can use 2 and just make sure that, again, I'm gonna show you. When you go to strum, you're using this part of the nail to make contact with the string, okay? That way you will end up with far fewer hangnails and other little minor finger injuries as you play. All right, and it sounds good. It acts like a pick, right? I like to use all four of my fingers. I'm a little weird like that. And it does become useful when you learn some more advanced strumming techniques. But do what feels comfortable for you. Some people like to use just one. I think that's a little too soft, so I'd encourage you to at least try to do two fingers, all right? But pick what works for you. Okay, so we're gonna do down strums, and it's just... which is A minor, G, F, C, G, F, C. All right? Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. Now, second verse. And when the brokenhearted people living in this point. There's usually an instrumental. It goes on for a while. It's a little more complicated, so I'm not going to go over it in this tutorial, since this focusing is on beginners. But at this point, we would normally sing the chorus one more time after that instrumental, and then we would go to the third verse. So I'm going to pretend we already did the chorus, because we just did two rounds of it. And we're going to go to the third verse. We're going to start with our C. And when the night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Now the chorus, let it be. Is in the PDF document, so you can follow along with me. But essentially, you're just singing that chorus. Like if we call those first two lines just a section of one, you do it three times. And then just a little extra something. There's a beginning part that this is not for my beginners. This is for people who are just learning the song and want to find these other parts. There's like a little turnaround in the very beginning of the song. So I wanted to show that to you real quick. And like I said, if you're a beginner, you don't have to learn this part because it might be a little bit too intimidating. But I'm going to show you for the rest of you out there. So there's a walk down that you start with the F chord and you just pluck all four strings with your thumb, index, middle, and ring. And then you're going to take your middle and ring finger and place them. Middle finger goes on the E string, third fret. Ring finger goes on the fourth fret of the C string, and you're going to pluck those two strings, and then you're going to slide that shape all the way up to the first and second fret, and then you're going to hit the C, all four strings. So when you play it all together, it sounds like this. Oops. helps if you do it right the first time. Let's try it again. So that's what it sounds like. And you can start the song that way. So if you were doing the intro, you could do... So this would be the... Alright. So that's just a little extra something if you wanted to learn that. Alright. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comment box. If you have any suggestions of songs you'd really like to learn that you haven't been able to find on the internet, hit me up. See if I can help you out. I'm always trying to find ways to bring songs to people on the ukulele that I haven't found before. So let me know if there's something you're dying to learn, and I will see if I can help you figure it out. All right. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.